The Mexico mission trip relocated this year to the Yucatan Peninsula. On March 23, 1990, we left the cold weather in Minneapolis and arrived shortly in sunny Cancun, Mexico, where it was 85 degrees. From there, we took a six-hour bus ride to Chuberna and arrived late that night.
What do you think of Chuberna?
Of what?
Oh, it's really pretty.
I love it. This is the way I like to live.
Well, it's not bad, you know. I mean, as long as it doesn't rain, because I have a nice sunlight over my bed, you know. So
I love the hammock. Like swinging to sleep. It was great. Snoring.
You can't touch this. You can't touch this.
My music hits me so hard, makes me say, oh my Lord, thank you for blessing me. What am I too loud and too hype? It feels good when you know you're down. A super dope homeboy from the Oak Town, and I'm known as such. And this is a beat you can't touch. I told you, homeboy, you can't touch this. Yeah, that's how we living, and you know you can't touch this.
Each day we awoke from our hammocks around 7 a.m. The girls stayed in homes of locals, but the guys weren't as lucky.
How do you feel about the living conditions so far?
Blatant sexism. The girls are living in a condo and we are living in an Iranian prison.
After a hearty breakfast prepared by various kitchen crews, we were off to work.
Isn't that beautiful sausage patty we have today?
Mexican secret. Did you see those dogs running around yesterday? Notice how they're not here today?
The what?
Omelette.
Oh, it was good. And those little fruit things, I ate everybody else's one of those because they didn't like them. It was real good. Larry does a good job.
The first day, we all worked on a building at the camp, leveling the floor and roofing it wrong.
Beam's got to come back to the west, guys. Take some weight off it, and it's got to go west.
I know, but
it's west.
We really didn't screw up. We were just following directions, though I know that happens very often. This morning we have to move the roof towards the ocean about 4 feet. We cantilevered the roof over the wrong side. Per instruction, of course, we didn't. It's very disappointing, though. You've gone through all that work, and now we have to move it back. But we should be able to have it fixed up in about 3 hours or so.
At first, work was scarce for girls. Well, it depends on what kind of work you are talking about.
How do you feel about your contribution to the work so far?
Well, I feel that in order to do a really good job, we need to walk on the beach and get tan first. So, you know, what we did yesterday, yeah, so we look like the Mexicans, you know, so we'll blend into the culture and everything. So, you know, what the girls did yesterday, you know, there was a lack of work for us, but we still got, you know, that part of the work done. See, so guys don't look like Mexicans yet, so, you know, we're ready to work now today. I mean,
put up beams and stones on two houses and
blocks,
whatever you call them, I don't know. And then the three of us here just moved 28 buckets of sand by ourselves with one shovel and two buckets. Well, we've been working pretty hard today.
The second day, half of our missionaries went to Merida, where we roofed 10 homes, quickly surpassing our goal of 6. Our work varied. Our main project was roofing. To put on a roof in Mexico, first we hoisted up cement beams. Then a line of workers was formed to haul up concrete bricks.
That's hard work. Teamwork, though. It always works.
Next, we foot mixed the cement and hauled it onto the roof by buckets. According to Mr. Takanen, there seemed to be a discrepancy among the workers of how long it actually took.
Guys, how long do you think it take you to build a house roof from start to finish?
10 minutes.
The ones we were doing today.
2 hours.
2 hours.
2 hours or 2 hours and 12 minutes?
2 hours.
2 hours.
That's okay,
it must have been longer than expected because we worked into the night. Each of us had new and different experiences. Some speaking Spanish for the first time, some had never played in the ocean. But an experience shared by all was knowing that by giving a week to people who don't have roofs over their heads can make a real difference. Although our journey was plagued by injuries, we were able to overcome them with the help of our nurse.
So Jake, what happened to your eye exactly?
I had stuff in it, sand, and it scratched the eyeball.
We're just going to bandage it up. And he, too, will wear a splint like Pastor Rich.
Batman bandage.
Can I just get a little bag?
Well, some people can't apply sunblock evenly to other people's backs. That'd be my mom.
Is it true that you can put your gum in your mouth and make it come out your nose?
Yeah.
Can we see it?
No, I don't got any gum, and I'm not going to do it on camera.
Pop proved to be more than just a refreshment. It accompanied our every meal.
How much pop do you think we'll go through this week?
Either of
them. Well,
okay. 5 to 6 a day, because they'll, you know, 3 for sure in each meal, and then, you know, 3 throughout the day.
Or more, because a lot of people have it before bed, brush their teeth with it, and...
Yeah.
Pop has many uses down here.
and the big beefy men need at least like 10, yeah, you know, to yeah. keep up their strength.
Like
and
you, Matt, you need like...
Showers seemed to be an inconsistency within the group. For most, they were few and far between.
But, you know, after we work and everything, so I'm clean for the next day, but, you know, our shower, it really sucks. It's just like being squirted with a water pistol, so I'll probably take about, 20 showers.
All right. Andrew, how many showers have you taken?
The showerless motif here.
Each day ended with devotions by either Kari, Tom, or Rich, and singing with Kim. Mauricio, our site coordinator and translator, was more than satisfied with our work.
How do you feel about this trip?
I feel great going back home. I feel very happy what you done and we done this year. We can do better less next year or next. I think we'll be better and greater than this.
If you have a word to say to all the people back home, what is it?
Hi. Hola. thank you for let your kids come to Merida. I was worried the first days, but when I found that everything is security here, I feel relief and I feel very happy. And I'm not worried for you. We are in a security place and no problem.
Thank you.
Following communion, we dug out the cross that we had made and erected it alongside the building that we had roofed. It represented 68 missionaries, the hard work that they did in 1990, a tradition, and an unforgettable experience. A little of all of us was left behind in Chuburna.
When you're down and troubled and you need a helping hand and nothing, oh, nothing's going right, close your eyes and think of me and soon I will be there to brighten up even your darkest night. You just call up my name and you know wherever I am I'll come running, oh yeah baby, to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, fall. All you got to do is call and I'll be there, yeah, yeah, yeah. You've got a friend. If the sky above you should turn dark and full of clouds and that old north wind should look in the blow, keep your head together and call my name out loud now. Soon I'll be knocking on your door. You just call up my name and you know wherever I am I'll come running, oh yes I will see you again. Winter, spring, summer or fall, got to do is call and I'll be there, yeah, yeah, yeah. Hey, ain't it good to know that you've got a friend? People can be so cold, they'll hurt you and desert you. Well, they'll take your soul if you let them. Oh yeah, but don't you let them. You just call out my name and you know wherever I am I'll come running to see you again. Oh baby, don't you know about winter, spring, summer, fall? Hey now, all you've got to do is call. Lord, I'll be there, yes I will. You've got a friend. You've got a friend, yeah. Ain't it good to know you've got a friend? Ain't it good to know you've got a friend? Oh yeah, yeah, you've got a friend.
This is your brain. I'll tell you once more. This is your brain. That is your brain doing mission work under the Mexican sun. And this is your brain under Mexican sun after you cook for people.